Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Welcome to St. Boniface. A blessed Easter to each of you as we celebrate today the resurrection of the Lord. Everything you will need for today's service is contained in the worship aids that were handed out as you entered the church. If you did not receive one, you will find them available on the table at the side entrance and available from the hospitality ministers or the table at the main entrance of the church. Our celebrant this morning is our associate pastor, Father Quan Nguyen. On behalf of Father Quan and the St. Boniface community, we welcome those of you visiting with us this morning, and we thank you for making a choice to add your prayers to ours on this blessed Easter day. Before we get started this morning, I would like to remind those in our lay ministries program that you will find the sign-up book available at the guest information area located next to the main entrance of the church. Positions are always available for altar server, lector, gift bearer, and Eucharistic minister. If you can assist us in one of those areas on a Sunday morning, please sign up for the appropriate Sunday and Mass time at which you are available. If you have questions about those positions, I will be glad to speak with you further about it. Ladies and gentlemen, we will conclude today's liturgy with the thing I'm sure everyone came here to see, and that is the presentation of the risen Lord. It is a special feature here at St. Boniface that has taken place every Easter since 1901, and we are proud to continue that tradition today. We are glad to have you with us for that this morning. And a reminder that you're always welcome to join us here at St. Boniface every Sunday. We're here at 8:30 and 11 a.m. We thank you for being here this morning. We look forward to you coming back in the near future.
Good morning and welcome to St. Boniface. Our opening hymn is located on the inside cover of your program, Christ the Lord is Risen Today. Please stand.
Christ the Lord is risen today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning and happy Easter to everybody. So today we celebrate the Easter Sunday. Today we remember we have wonderful time of the Lenten season. We have wonderful time of the Holy Week. And today we celebrate the most important day of the year, the most important time of the Holy Week. Today Jesus rose from the dead. And today we celebrate hope, love, peace, and light. Let's open our mind, open our heart, open our soul to participate in this celebration. I confess, and to you, my brothers and sisters, my brothers and sisters, my God and my wife, to my fault. To my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant we pray that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, may through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through Lord Jesus Christ, our Son, who lives and reigns with you in his unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. The man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our Paschal Lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Christiani, agnus redemptoris. angelicos testes, sudarium et vestes, surrexit Christus spes mea, precedet suos in Galilea. Scimus Christum surrexisse, amor tuis vere, tu nobis victorex miserere. Amen. Alleluia.
From Holy Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, everybody. So Christ is risen, alleluia, alleluia. So today we celebrate the greatest time of the church year, and we celebrate the most important day of Christian faith. And today we celebrate the triumph of good over evil, light over darkness, peace over conflicts. And today we celebrate hope, peace, and the fulfillment of God's promises to the mankind and to each one of us. And the Easter Sunday, the Easter mystery, reminds each one of us that Jesus is the God of the living and the dead. My dear friends, on Good Friday, many people thought it was over. Jesus is dead and buried. Jesus is finished. However, they did not know that there was one more chapter left in the life story of Jesus Christ. And they did not know that there is victory over defeat. There is life after darkness, and there is joy after grief. And that's why St. Paul said to each one of us, if Jesus Christ has not been raised, then our preaching is in vain and your faith is in vain. My dear friends, if there was no Easter, no resurrection, so the road to salvation could not be complete. That's why today our faith must be the Easter faith, and our human life doesn't end on Good Friday or at Calvary. However, today we look forward to the Easter that is today. My dear friends, one of the most important images in the Gospel is the removed stone. And St. John tells one of us in the Gospel, Mary Magdalene goes to the tomb, and the four Gospels mentions the stone was removed from the tomb. So what does the removed stone mean to you and to me, to each one of us? So the removed stone means resurrection. The removed stone means a new relationship with God. The removed stone means a new life, a new day, a new way. And the removed stone means death is not an end, and human history doesn't end at the stone, because today it encounters the living stone that is Jesus Christ. My dear friends, in our life, each one of us is dealing with many forms, many kinds of stone of our life. They may be stone of selfishness, the stone of envy, the stone of disappointment, the stone of selfishness, the stone of hatred, the stone of envy, and they may be the stone of the desire for material possession, or they may be the stone of our spiritual life. That's why we ask each one of us this question: do we allow these stones to prevent each one of us from meeting with Jesus Christ? Or do we allow these stones to block our ways to God in our life? And we know that these stones are very dangerous to our spiritual life, very dangerous to our relationship with God and with others. That's why today we are called to allow Jeus, allow the risen Christ to remove these stones of our life, in our hearts, in our family, in our community, and in our life. And we believe that we are not strong enough to remove the stone of our life. So, who can help each one of us to remove the stone? So we believe that there is only one who can help each one of us to remove the stone of our life. That is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ gives each one of us His power to remove the stone in our hearts and to remove all barriers in our family, in our community, in our church, and in our life. That's why we are called to be more willing to allow Jesus to remove any kinds of storm of our life. My dear friends, today is a day of joy. Today we rejoice. As St. Augustine says, we are Easter people, and Alleluia is our song. We are Easter people, and Alleluia is our song. So today we sing Alleluia in a special way. We sing Alleluia not only today, but every day, every moment in our life. We sing Alleluia in our circumstances. We sing Alleluia in our situations. We are in a time of sickness or illness, singing Alleluia. We are in a time of fear or disappointments, singing Alleluia. We are in a time of loneliness or righteous or any kind of anxiety, singing Alleluia. We are in a time of weaknesses or sins, singing Alleluia, because we are Easter people and Alleluia is our song. My dear friends, the moment of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ is not just in the past or not just in the future, but the moment of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ is right here, right now, and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ is happening to each one of us every day, every moment in our life. And we experience the moment of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ when hope overcomes despair, when love overcomes hatred, when forgiveness overcomes revenge, when sacrifice overcomes selfishness and laziness, and when we allow God to be present in our life, when we allow God to change our hearts, to renew our soul, to refresh our life. My dear friends, in doing so, we make Jesus alive always, every day in our life. And the Easter Sunday is not only today, but all the day of our life. My dear friends, Easter Sunday is about removing the stone of our life, and Easter Sunday is about Jesus giving each one of us His peace, His hope, His love, and His light. And we believe that God is always with us. God is always abiding us. And if we are not happy, remove the stone. If we are not willing to come to Jesus, remove the stone. If we are not ready to receive the Holy Communion, remove the stone. If we are not ready to allow God to change our life, remove the stone, because today we encounter the living stone, that is Jesus Christ. My dear friends, today when we celebrate the Easter Sunday, we also celebrate new hope, new commitment, new peace in God, in Jesus Christ. May the light of Jesus give each one of us His peace, His joy, and His happiness, so that we can live this mystery every day in our life. And may the light of the Easter give us eternal life. Amen. Please stand. My dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Jesus Christ in baptism so that we may walk with Him in newness of life. And now let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan and on his works and on his empty show? Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God? Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you? Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, O Lord, who was born of Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth in water and the Holy Spirit, and bestow on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by His grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, Christ is risen indeed. Trusting in God, His love and mercy and providence, let's offer to Him our prayers and petitions.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. That all church leaders will be renewed by their mission of leading all people to Jesus Christ, the risen Lord, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For deeper unity among all Christians as they acknowledge together and proclaim to the world the resurrection of Jesus the Christ, we pray to the Lord. That the risen Christ may bless, guide and protect all who serve in public office, that they may serve with dignity and righteousness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Jesus, who conquered the power of death, may give our society the strength to protect every human life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may be comforted with healing, and that all who have died may share in the resurrection of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Let us bring before the Lord the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. For the eternal repose of the soul of Joseph Shooter and the people of St. Boniface Parish, that the Lord may graciously hear and answer our prayers, let us pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, thank you for the gift of faith, gift of hope, gift of love, gift of the resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, in which we receive true light and salvation. Receive and answer our prayers in your love and mercy, according to your holy will. We ask this through Christ, O Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of our hands. For the praise and glory of his name, our good of all his virtue. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ, O Lord. The Lord be with you. Thus our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to Lord Jesus more gloriously, when Jesus Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restore our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people is so sins of praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of the glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. But holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Shelton, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Boniface, and honored saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Seventh commandment, and formed by the teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, forgive us our trespasses. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the same peace.
I think it's just two, isn't it?
Two.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy you should enter under my roof, but at least say a word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that, renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ, O Lord. Amen. Again, thank you very much for your participation today in this Mass, and especially thank you the choirs for your great service, great music today. Thank you very much. And I'm grateful to those who did decoration and preparation for today's Mass, especially during Lenten season and during Holy Week. Thank you very much for your sacrifice, for your love to serve our community. And happy Easter again. And I hope and pray you have a wonderful and blessed holy season of Easter, full of hope, love, joy, and peace. Happy Easter. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for blessing. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity and in His compassion defend you from every assault of sin. Amen. And may He who restore you to eternal life in the resurrection of His only begotten Son endow you with the price of immortality. Amen. And now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Jesus Christ's help and exhorting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia, Alleluia.
Praise to God.